Let's keep going. God damn, these puzzles. Sheesh. What's that sound? Is he gonna be behind the door? Of course, security cam footage. I've been watched the whole time. Yep, there's the security camera right when I barely walk by.
Someone's been watching.
But who? Oh.
Lily. Whoever's been here was gathering data on her.
Wow. Oh my god.
Don't move.
You're Mobius, right?
Shut up! Don't say a word! You're not one of us.
No, I'm not. Kidman sent me. Look, I'm here to help, okay? My name is Sebastian Castellanos.
You're lying. Sebastian Castellanos is dead.
What? No. Who told you that?
Turn around. Do it slow.
You're Yukiko Hoffman.
How do you know my name?
I told you. They sent me in here to find my daughter Lily. The Corps. I'm telling you the truth.
I know.
You do?
Lack of microexpressions and deflection. No verbal parroting. I've seen enough to know you're telling the truth.
Right. The team psychologist.
I have to use whatever tools I have to survive. Combat isn't my forte.
Seems to be a running theme here.
Sorry for pointing my gun at you. So they're sending independent contractors now? That means things aren't improving. Have you found any other team members?
I have, but the only one I've found alive is O'Neill.
Liam is alive? Good. Has he made any progress on stabilization?
The big emitter's back on, but this place is still falling apart. And I think it's all because of this psycho that kidnapped Lily. He's running loose in Union and can manipulate this place at will.
That means my theory is correct. This is more than a core disconnect. We doctors don't like to use the term psycho in pejorative terms. But in this case, it's apropos. Only a clinically diagnosed psychopath could affect STEM like this. A psychopathic personality type using Lily to amplify his power. This is the worst possible situation.
You're a shrink. Any suggestions on how to defeat him?
Psychopaths are antisocial, lack empathy, and exhibit sadistic tendencies. But their main commonality is their pathologic egocentricity. They don't care about people, only themselves. Can you think of anything that would be important to him?
Yeah. He thinks he's some sort of artist. It's all he talks about.
Then maybe the best way to attack him would be through his art. Destroying something valuable to him could knock him off of his guard.
I'll keep that in mind. But I've got to get to him first. He's holed himself up in the theater.
Right. So exit D5 then. It's right here, just in the next room. Let's pair our communicators so that we can stay in touch. I'll review my files and see if I can't dig up any more information about what's going on. I still feel like there's more to this. Regardless, he's probably going to be difficult to fight. Feel free to help yourself to anything here you might need.
Well, alright then, Yukiko.
You said there's something more to this?
I studied the Beacon incident extensively so that we could avoid another disaster like that. In that case, the person in question was the Corps. But even then, the environment remained relatively intact. Something just doesn't seem right here.
What do you mean?
The creatures in here. The dissolution of Union. The total breakdown in communication with Mobius. It just seems like a lot for one person. Even with the power of the Corps.
He mentioned someone before. Another person who wanted the Corps' power.
That could mean... No. It's too horrible to contemplate.
What?
There's only one thing that could be more powerful than a psychopath in here. But I need to do some research before I can commit to the theory.
Wow, she's playing the pronoun game.
If Mobius knew to keep psychopaths out of STEM, then how did one end up in here?
I don't know. Every individual in STEM was subjected to a battery of psychological exams prior to placement. And we've been observing them from here, in secret, to keep an eye out for mental instability.
Yeah. Well, that didn't work.
Unfortunately, psychopathy and sociopathy are incredibly difficult to diagnose correctly. Psychopaths tend to be cunning and highly intelligent. Aware of their own diagnosis, they're able to disguise themselves among us. The fact that this one was able to fool us, he's obviously adroit and self-aware. Disturbingly so.
Great. So the tests only filtered out the weakest of psychos.
I feel terribly responsible for all of this. I helped devise those tests.
So does Lily really think I'm dead? Or was that just a part of your lie-detecting test?
Sorry to break it to you, but she does. I thought it was the truth, too, until just now. But over the years, I've learned to take everything Mobius tells me with a pinch of salt. It wasn't difficult to see you were telling the truth.
Why would they do that? What kind of monsters do you work for?
I know it's not right. But consider this. Lily is probably less traumatized by thinking you're dead than by thinking you're alive, but she can't be with you.
Yeah, maybe. But what will happen when I finally find her?
Don't worry. She'll believe the evidence of her eyes once she sees you.
Well, all right then. Trophy earned the team psychologist. Well, it was kind of weird. I thought she was just messing around, but she was actually telling the truth. Supposedly Sebastian died. Horrible. Supposedly Lily thinks he's dead. I don't need that. But I'm just gonna look around, grab the stuff I can get like this. Red gel, gunpowder, I don't need that. Wow. Wait, she sat down? Huh. Did we even pair communicators? Way. Nope, okay. Alright, let me go through the thing and make some more ammo. But anyways, it's kind of weird though. Whoa. Why is it all pixelated? Well, not pixelated, but... You saw the... little white dots. I'm still wondering where... Oh, there's the mask. I see it. I want to go take a look at those things. I didn't think it was just right here. Yeah, that's obviously the dog from Wolfenstein. And that's the mask from Dishonored. I don't know, really. The rocket launcher does look familiar, but I'm not sure. And the Pip-Boy, well, we already know where the Pip-Boy is. I mean, the Vault-Boy. I keep thinking Pip-Boy, though. Let's check out that new slide that we got. Excuse me, cat. Guess we got our new slide.
Pick up, Kidman.
I'm here.
The first time I saw Myra, she was wearing that uniform. I think I fell in love with her right then and there. I didn't want to admit it to myself. But after she was injured on duty, I knew I couldn't risk not telling her how I felt. She was such a great wife and mother that I sometimes forget she was a great detective, too. She was right. She knew there was something fishy about Lily's death. I mean, kidnapping. I should have believed her from the start.
There's no way you could have predicted the truth, Sebastian. You know this.
Yeah. So I guess they both worked on the... I guess they both worked on the same force. Thank you, Cat, for the 700 green gel. Alright, let's head to the workbench. 555. Yeah, I'm completely out of ammo. About 12 should do it. Oh man, that's so much. God. Look at that. From like, I think I had 55 of that, and now I'm down to 27, 23 now. Which. I ended up buying this one, except the fire rate is kind of low. That doesn't really matter. I don't need the weapon sway. It's 105 also. Do I really want to? I guess. Yeah, I don't need that. Up to 10. Wow, it goes up to 2. Okay. I think I mostly need the firepower. That's about it. Alright. Let's go see Tatiana. Is she gonna jump scare me again?
What can I help you with, Detective?
Oh, there she is.
You seem more at ease, Detective.
Yep.
You've found a possible ally in this dangerous world.
Not sure about that. I never know who to trust in here. Present company included.
A shame. After all we've been through together, isolation and distrust aren't symptoms of mental illness, but they are unfortunate byproducts of it. Closing yourself off from others does nothing but agitate your condition. You are human. You require connection the way a plant requires light.
Wow.
The only connection I require right now is to your machine. I've still got a long road ahead of me.
Well, that was interesting.
Don't you think?
All right, then. I thought she was going to say more to me, but... Wait. Oh, yeah, I can't grab that. I can grab this one. Nope, I can't actually. Alright, what's in the next locker? Okay. I really don't use the harpoon bolts. Oh. Alright, that was worth it. Alright, let's check this out. I kind of wished you could walk around more though, like in the previous one. Yes. Cover near a wall, and then sneak kill when the sneak kill kind of disappeared. Oh, it displayed. When you're in a corner on a corner, when you're in cover on a corner, whoops, you can perform a sneak kill on an enemy that is around the corner. The enemy must be in the center of the screen for the sneak kill icon to appear. You cannot perform a sneak kill if the enemy is aware of you. Okay. Maybe. Yeah, it's, I kind of do want to make him move a little bit faster. Special ability which allows you to quickly close on enemy for a chance to sneak kill them. Okay. The health is pretty important, though. Automatically use a medical syringe when taking fatal damage. Does not work when taking fatal damage from certain attacks. 5,000... I'm mostly just focusing on recovery. For a set amount of time, shooting damage is increased with each consecutive shot. The effect ends when you either time or ammunition runs out. Well, yeah, didn't I get something that... I should probably use this one, actually. The kick. Oh, there it is, the synaptic focus. But that's later. Alright, I think we're good. Let's head back out. Actually, wait a minute. I can craft a little bit more bullets. Since I got 63 again. Alright, 22 should be fine. Explosive bolts. I'll craft one. I'm gonna start using the crossbow a little bit more. Let's check if everything's reloaded. Not that one. Alright, yeah, we're good. Let's go back to the mirror. She's just watching. Alright, let's investigate this. Email core candidates to all concerned from Operative Grisham. Read Lily Castellanos' initial findings. The ideal core candidate must have an unfettered ego in order to retain their own personality, while supporting the interlinked minds of many others. Given these parameters, there are only two possible candidate types: egomaniacs with psychopathic tendencies, or children. We all know what happened the last time an egomaniac with psychopathic tendencies was in STEM, so a child is our best bet. Having access to standardized school test results, we were able to narrow down our options. We feel that we found the ideal core candidates in Lily Castellanos. Her tests show that she not only has a guileless ego, but she also exhibits incredibly advanced empathy for a child her age. We are sending her to Dr. Hoffman for further testing. Wow. 22 of 40. Alright guys, I think that's probably the end of it. I think I've been going for a while now. But I want to say thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe. We're on chapter 6 on the hunt. And as always, gamers, remember, leave a like, share, comment, subscribe, and remember, gamers, keep on gaming. Take care, everyone. Alright, guys, welcome back. We're going to continue on from when we last left off. We met Yukiko Hoffman, I believe that's what her last name was. But yeah, it's Yukiko, her first name. Yeah, we just happened to meet her here in this underground area. Alright. Nothing. Nope. Okay, let's go through the computer. But yeah, we're heading to, I believe it was the theater, he said. Pass through the Morrow and search for exit D5. What was that? Something was loading up on the left side. And then the right side. Actually, wait a minute. I think the rocket launcher is supposed to be from Team Fortress. But I could be wrong. It looks like not the original rocket launcher that a soldier had, but it's like the other ones you can get. Ooh, high-grade weapon parts. Alright. Yeah, I always want to save those just in case I want something better so I don't waste them. But now that I got one more, I can use it. God damn. Stupid. I'm pretty sure that was there to jump scare. Alright. I'll come back for you harpoon bolts. And there's another save file. Ooh. Okay. Nope, we can't search it. Alright, let's check what this is about. Just need to get into that storage room.
Damn it. Can't feel my hand.
Ow.
That thing nearly tore my arm off. Never gonna kill it with this pea shooter. Need something bigger. I just need to get into that storage room outside the safe house.
Oh, wow.
I'm tired. Just gotta rest here and wait for Stevens.
Oh, man, so I guess residual memories 9 of 24. My guess is the guy probably died from blood loss. I don't think something came to kill him. Yeah, that's probably blood loss. God, I pray it wasn't a saint. Oh, wait. When she mentioned there's probably another person, that got me thinking. It's probably right.
The theater. I'm coming for you.
Okay, but anyways, that reminded me that it's probably the main villain from the first game coming back. Oh, great. Wait, and that's not what I meant. Wow. I guess this is where I was before. Oh, okay. So I'm in the business district. Let's look around. Some more trains. Yeah, he's crawling a little bit faster, which I do like. She almost threw me in the camouflage. Oh crap, damn. When was she able to do that? Come on, Sebastian, recover faster. I honestly don't remember her being able to do that, where she just throws a whole lot of acid in a certain spot. God, she is hunting me down, guys. God, she is literally trying to kill me now. Oh, man. Oh, my God, what the hell? God, I guess there's new creatures now. And they can throw tomahawks now. God, or whatever that was, a knife?
Next time I might not be so lucky.
Nah, you got this, Sebastian. You'll be A-okay. She goes. I wonder if she's the one that threw that damn tomahawk at me. God, stop running so fast. I see that.